Good morning, children. The lesson 11, ratio and proportion. Okay. So in the previous classes, we have learned to compare two quantities or two numbers. We shall now learn another way to the same. Now see, children, an example is given in your book. A boy says, I am younger than Nilima by 6 years. And the girl says, I am twice as old as Ramesh. So here is the comparison. I am younger than Nilima by 6 years. So how will you compare? You will compare it by subtraction. Okay. Let's see, Nilima 12 years old and Ramesh is 6. How to compare their ages now? See, children, here both should be given in the same unit. You cannot compare the weight of Nilima is 65 years and the age of Ramesh is 5 years. Here, kg and years. One thing is the measure of mass and another is the time. You cannot compare these two things. So, very first, you must know beta, while comparing, they should be in the same kind, like age and the mass. You can't compare. Or the rupees and the liter. You can't compare. So, both should be in the same. Now, so children, one example is what beta? In our daily life, we have often to compare two quantities either by terms of their magnitude or their measurements. For example, in an examination, Ravi got 76 marks out of 100 and Raman got 50 marks out of 100. Their performance can be compared. Okay, so here the comparison between Ravi and Raman is given. Now you first compare these two quantities. See, children, they are of the same point. Mass, mass. 100, 100. Okay. They are is of same kind. So first you can compare by subtraction. How will you compare them by subtraction? So first we will compare them by subtraction. Comparison. By subtraction. So 76 upon 100 minus 50 upon 100, that is 26 upon 100. So it is what beta? Comparison by subtraction. Now you will compare it by average, means divided by 100. What you mean? So Ravi got 26% more than Raman. Ravi got 10 by Raman. Now by average, Ravi got
or will you compare them by average?
76 plus 50 divided by 2. Average it is. You have to add the terms and divide it by the number of terms. So it is not 6. So how will you compare it by average? So Ravi had got 13% more than Raman, or less than the average, and Raman had got 13% less than the average marks. Okay, now let's compare these two quantities by division. Ravi scored 76 upon 50. Okay, reduce these two things. What you get? 38 upon 50. 38 upon 25. So here we cancel them by 2. That means what? The comparison by division is called ratio. Comparison. See, how will you read it? 38 upon 20. So how will you read? 38 is to 25. So it 38 is to 25 is the ratio of the marks of Ravi and Raman. Got it better? So what is ratio? Ratio is the comparison by division. And quantities must be the same kind. Got it, children? So, ratio is the comparison. Got it better? What is ratio? Ratio is the comparison. The ratio of two numbers A and B, where B should not be zero. B means denominator, is A upon B, where B should not be zero.
is denoted by A is to B. So how will you read these two dots? A is to B, where A and B are called the terms of the ratio. The first term see children here A is the first term and B is the another term means here A is the first and B is the another term so A is called antecedent and B is called consequent the first term is called antecedent So always children, the first term is antecedent and the second term is consequent. And one more important thing is comparison is always done in the same quantity or same kind of the should be the same. Third point. The next point is what? The order of the terms in a ratio is important. the order of the terms in the ratio is important, means beta. So here you can't change the order of the operation. Why? Because always the first term becomes numerator and the second term becomes denominator. So here you can't change their sequence. That is, the ratio of, for example, is to 3 is different from the ratio of ratio of 3:2. See children, what is the meaning of 2:3? It is 2/3. And here 3:2 means 3/2. Here numerator is 2 and here numerator is 3. Here the denominator is 3 and here the denominator is 2. And both are the different. It just because of changing the order of the equation. Got it, Peter? Next point. Ratio of two quantities is just a number and has no unit at all. Means, see children, if you compare the height of two students, one is 5 feet and another is 4.5 feet. So ratio is 5:4.5. You can't write here feet or the weight of two things. One is 10 kg and another is 11 kg. So ratio is 10:11. You can't say 10:11 kg. So you have to remember this thing better while you write any number or in the form of ratio or in the form of comparison by division. So don't write unit. Got it, children? So here we are stop, beta. Bye bye, children. Bye bye, beta.